Music and sound effects are one of the most important parts of a game, and they can make a huge difference adding to the mood and feel of the game. Let's take a look at how to add sounds to our platformer example we've been setting up. If you haven't seen the first two videos where we set everything up, check the links in the description to get caught up. Also, links to all of the assets used in this video are in the description too. I have four audio files here, each of them in OGG format, three sound effects, and one song. First, we need to add the audio files to the project. To do this, just select all the audio files you want to use and drag them into the Sounds folder in the Project panel. Construct will encode them, and when it's finished, go ahead and click Import. I'll drag the Symphony Mystical Town 1 file down into the Music folder. The reason you want to put your music files in the Music folder is because any audio files in the Sounds folder are preloaded before the layout begins, which means they are always ready to play. Audio files in the Music folder are streamed and are not preloaded at all. This is good for music, since it helps get the player into the game faster without needing to download a full song before gameplay begins. To play audio files in the game, we need to add the audio object to the project. The audio object allows us to play sounds and music, set the panning, volume, effects, and so on. Double-click the layout and choose the audio object under the Media category. Once you add it to the project, it's available for use in the event sheet. There's no need to drag it onto the layout. Now that we have our audio files added to the project, we can start to trigger them when the various events occur. Let's switch to the event sheet and use the audio object to play these sounds. There are three events that we're going to enhance with a sound effect: when the player collects an orange mushroom, when they collect a pink mushroom, and when they die from falling off the edge of the platform. We already have two of these events set up here. Let's add an action under the orange mushroom collision event and choose the audio object. We've got a bunch of options here, but for now, we're going to keep it simple and just choose the first option, play. Here, we can choose the audio file we want to use out of all the files we imported earlier. I'll use item miscellaneous 1. You can set whether or not the audio will be looping or not, and since this is a sound effect, we don't want it to loop. You can also lower the volume by entering a negative value here, but you're not able to raise the volume by entering a positive value. 0 is as loud as it can go. Adding a tag for the sound lets you refer to it later in the event sheet to perform other actions on, which we don't need for this example, so just go ahead and click Done. Select the play audio action that we just created, hold down the Control key, and drag a copy of the action out onto the pink mushroom collision event. Double-click the action to change the audio file that's played, and choose Wood 2. Hit F5 to preview the layout, and as the dinosaur collects the mushrooms, we hear our sound effects. Next, we want to play a sound when the player dies, if they fall off the side of the platform. To do this, we're going to add a behavior to the player. So with the player selected, click Behaviors, and add New. Under the General category, select the Destroy Outside of Layout behavior. So, if the player object leaves the screen, it will be destroyed. In the event sheet, add an event using the player object, and under miscellaneous, choose the onDestroyed event. So, this will be triggered when the player is destroyed, when they leave the screen. Drag a copy of the play audio action down to the onDestroyed event, double-click the action, and change the audio file to Creature Roar 2, and click Done. Preview with F5, and if we jump off the side, you can hear when the player is destroyed. Last, we want to have some background music playing. Let's add another event, using the System object, and choose On Start of Layout. Again, drag down a copy of the play audio action and double-click it to change the audio file. I'll choose Symphony Mystical Town 1, but this time I'll change Loop to Looping. Since this is our background music, we want to keep it playing during the whole level, so it needs to restart once it's finished. Go ahead and click Done. This is basically finished, but there is one issue. For the game to start playing audio, the window has to be activated by clicking on it. If I press F5 to preview the game, there will be no music until I click on the window. But in the context of a full game, the user will have already clicked and activated the window on the start screen. Now, you might want to play music on the start screen as well. And to do that, just drag your music file into the sounds folder. That causes it to be loaded before the layout begins, and you won't need to click the window for the music to start. If we press F5 to preview the game, the background music plays, as well as our other sound effects when we collect mushrooms and fall off the side of the platform. That covers the basics of playing sound effects and background music in a Construct 3 project. Just import the audio files into the project, add the audio object to the project, and use it to play sounds as events are triggered.